Hi students, in this video we will solve this problem. From top of a building, the angle of elevation of top of a cell tower is 60 degrees. So there is a building and there is a cell tower, right? So see, suppose this is the building. Alright? And this is the cell tower. How can we say that cell tower is bigger than the building? See, it is given that. From top of a building, so you are standing on top of a building and the angle of elevation of top of a cell tower, this is the top of a cell tower and you are seeing up, only then the angle of elevation will be formed, isn't it? So that way we can say building is smaller or tower is longer or taller than building, and angle of elevation is how much? 60 degrees, and the angle of depression to its foot is 45. From the same point, you are seeing the foot of this tower. Angle of depression is 45. Angle of elevation or depression is measured with respect to horizontal line, right? And this is the ground. Okay. What do we need to find? If the distance of the building from the tower is 7 meters, so this is 7 meters. This is building and this is the tower. Okay, find the height of the tower. We need to find the height of this tower. Let it be h. Okay, what do we need to do now? Alright, see here, if this is 45 degrees, this will also be 45 degrees, alternate interior angles, right? Because these two lines are parallel to each other, these two lines are parallel to each other, and this line is a transversal line. These two lines will be alternate interior angles. And in lower classes, we have studied that alternate interior angles will be equal. So if this is 45, this is also 45. So what I'll do is I'll drop this. Okay. All right. So this is 45. Let us name this A, B, C, D and E. Okay. See, we'll take this triangle ABC and find the height of the building. If we can find the height of the building, okay, height of the building will be 7. Okay, because we have 45 here. Okay, so this DC will be 7. We'll find how we get 7. See, DC will be 7. Now, if you take this triangle and find the value of ED, okay, and add that ED to 7, we'll get the height of the tower. Okay, this should be our approach. And this BC is 7, so this AD will also be equal to 7 meters. Let us take this triangle ABC. A, B and C. 45 degrees here and we don't know what is the height of the building. Let it be AB only. This is 7. Okay. We need to find this AB. AB is how much? See, 45 is here. So this one will be the opposite side. This one will be the adjacent side. Okay. Opposite and adjacent will come in tan formula, right? Sine, cos, tan. Cosecant, secant, cot. Old hero and his old acting. Opposite and adjacent will come in tan as well as in cot. So we can either use tan or cot. We will use tan now. Okay. So tan 45 degrees is equal to opposite side is AB divided by BC adjacent is 7. Tan 45 is 1. So we have AB divided by 7. 7 goes that side. Okay. AB will be equal to 7. So height of the building is 7. Okay, so if this is 7, this is also 7, right? DC will be 7. Let us take this triangle EDA and find the value of ED and then add it to 7. Okay, let me drop this. Let me write AB is equal to 7 here. Okay, let us take this triangle ED and this is A. This is 60 degrees and this is 7. Alright, see, 60 is here, we need to find ED, that means we need to find opposite and we know adjacent. Again, opposite and adjacent are in picture. So we can take tan value. Tan 60 is equal to opposite is ED divided by adjacent is 7. Tan 60 is root 3. Okay, this is ED divided by 7. If you cross multiply this, 7 root 3 will be equal to ED. Okay, 7 root 3 will be equal to ED. So how much is this now? This is 7 root 3. Now what is the height of the tower? 7 root 3 plus 7. It is 7 plus 7 root 3 or 7 root 3 plus 7. See, some students will add this 7 plus 7 and they will write 14 root 3, which is a common mistake. Okay, don't do that. How can we add this then? See, we can take 7 common and write 1 plus root 3 here. Alright, so it is 7, 1 plus, we know what is the value of root 3, 1.732 approximately, right? Let me just check whether this is visible in the board or not. Yes, I'll write it here now. This is 7, 1 plus 1 here will be 2.732. Now let us multiply this, 2.732 multiplied by 7. 14, 21, 22, 49, 51, 14, 19. So 19.124 meters is the height of the tower. Okay. I hope you all understood this problem. See you in the next video.